First and foremost, I'd like to go to Kavya Mukhija, because even as you know, we're seeing these protests and this talk about how the NTA has handled these entrance exams and these exams being cancelled, this massive controversy. Kavya had a very different experience also being, you know, on a wheelchair. She found that even the exam center where she was sent to was not disability friendly. It was not accessible. And that's also absolutely shocking that, you know, the NTA is not taking, you know, care to ensure that students have the access and are not facing further tension just getting to the exam center. Kavya, if you could share your experience with us.
Yes, absolutely. So like you already mentioned, I'm a wheelchair user and I was accompanied by my mother, who is also my caregiver, and she has to be with me all the time to ensure that I do all the activities. Now my center was in Rohini and we used our personal vehicle to go there. Upon reaching there, I got to know that the center was not accessible. The road outside, as we can already see, was full of barriers. It was broken, which meant that I could not sit on my wheelchair on the road itself. So my mother went to the security guard to talk to him if we could take our car inside the campus so that it was easier for me to sit in my wheelchair. At first he absolutely refused, but later my mother had to really make him understand that it was important for us to take the car inside, because otherwise it was not possible. It could be dangerous for me. I could have a fall. Later he agreed and we took the car inside. I sat in my wheelchair and was wheeled to the classroom. There was a ramp there, but this gradient was such that it could not be used. The gradient was very steep and four people had to push my wheelchair across the ramp to actually make me go inside the class. When I went inside the class, I saw that the tables and chairs were not accessible as well. They were joined, which meant that I could not use them. I brought it to the notice of the invigilator there, and she arranged a separate chair, a separate table for me. I used that, although it was not very comfortable to use, but then there was no option left at that point of time. Later, I also realized that the staff and the invigilators were very insensitive to me and my mother. Since she is my caregiver, she had to be with me around had to be around me to ensure that I did require her support and everything. But they did not allow her to be inside the campus, and she was asked to go outside.
And Kavya, this is after you filled in. This is after you filled in your form about, you know, there's a column that asks if whether you have any issues, disabilities, etc. And you fill that in. So one would have imagined that NTA being this, you know, professional agency that is supposed to be in charge of all these major exams, that this is something they would take care of then, ensure that you go to an accessible exam center.
Exactly. I had put in my disability details, including my disability percentage and my disability type, very clearly in the examination form. But despite that, the center, firstly, it was way too far from my residence. I had also punched in my address, because that is also one of the mandatory fields in the application form. And right. Despite that, the center that was allotted was way too far and not accessible.